Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good morning, colleagues. At the beginning, I would like to express my great appreciation to organizing committee for kind invitation to participate at this conference and to give the talk at this prestigious event. I would like to do some short introduction to the announcing topic, and I'm starting. The breakdown mechanism depends on the gas and its pressure and on the discharge system geometry. It's well known. In a free space where the device dielectric walls don't influence the planar formation, a Townsend or a streamer breakdown is realized. In long gas discharge tubes, the dielectric wall significantly changes the breakdown scenario. In this case, the ionization wave take part in the formation of the completed breakdown. To date, it found out that the wave breakdown, as a rule, is a two-stage process. The first stage corresponds to the direct ionization wave traveling from a high voltage electrode along the tube. The second stage corresponds to the back ionization wave. When it arrives at the high voltage electrode, the breakdown is complete. There is a strong difference between conditions for the direct and the back ionization wave. What does it mean? The direct ionization wave moves through a non-ionized gas, but the back wave moves through the plasma formed by a direct ionization wave. Some information about types of the ionization waves. These waves are divided into two groups, faster waves and slow waves. Faster waves move with very high velocities in the range of 10^9, 10^10 centimeter per second. Fast waves are excited by nanosecond pulses with a very high voltage amplitude of several hundred kilovolts. Fast waves are characterized by the high currents of kiloamps range and very bright light emission from their fronts. Slow waves are characterized by velocities below 10^9 centimeter per second. And slow waves are excited by pulses with moderate voltage amplitudes of several units or tens of kilovolts. Slow waves are characterized by much smaller currents and a much lower intensity of their glow compared to the fast waves. In both types of waves, their propagation is supported by displacement currents through the dielectric tube wall. Now I would like to show you illustrating sketch of the visual image of fast ionization wave and their electric scheme. The notations are shown here. What are the main features of fast ionization wave? Due to the high fast velocity, charge deposition on the tube surface has no time to happen. Therefore, this process does not play a significant role in the fast wave propagation. The mechanism of seed electrons appearance ahead of the fast wave front must be very rapid to provide the high fast wave velocity. Today, two mechanisms are assumed depending on the polarity of high voltage pulse initiating the fast wave. First, in the case of positive polarity, the main mechanism is the photonization. Second, in the case of negative polarity, the main mechanism is the ionization by runaway electrons. Short information about slow ionization wave. What are the main features of this wave? Contrary, in slow waves, near wall cathode or anode layer has time to be formed. It's important. This layer ensures the surface charge deposition during the slow wave movement. In the case of faster wave, the deposition was absent. The surface charges affect the electric potential distribution along the tube and therefore directly influence the slow wave velocity. This is why the slow waves can be called a really surface ionization wave. The low intensity of the glow at the slow wave front leads to a very low photonization efficiency. Thus, the photonization does not play any role in the slow wave propagation. In the cathode-directed slow wave, seed electrons are provided by the electron emission from the tube surface. In the anode-directed slow wave, seed electrons are provided by plasma electrons, drifting from the plasma column towards the front and ahead of it. Now about motivation of our work. Discharge in long capillary tubes is used in many gas discharge devices, for example, in laser gyroscopes, for which the reliability of the breakdown formation and the time for the discharge establishment are very important things. The breakdown in capillary tube is ruled by the slow ionization waves. Therefore, there is a great interest in the deep insight of these waves, in particular in clarifying such important issues such as A, the surface charge deposition dynamics during the direct slow wave propagation, the surface charge discharging dynamics during the back slow wave propagation, and the charge deposition and discharging correlation with the slow wave light emission. To date, insufficient attention was paid to these issues in the literature. We performed the appropriate experiments on the slow wave dynamics study in a long capillary tube filled with helium at low pressure. The slow wave was excited by a high voltage pulse of several kilovolts of positive and negative polarity. The preliminary created DC glow discharge influence on the slow wave propagation was studied. The various configurations of the electrode system were used in the experiments. Now, several words about key parameters of the used against discharge capillary quartz tubes. We used two quartz tubes with different construction of electrodes. The quartz tube, each quartz tube has a length of 300 millimeters. The inner and outer diameter are 2.4 and 4.2 millimeters. Two thin wall copper cylinders, this and this, of 25 millimeter in length are inner electrodes that are placed at the tube ends. The outer electrode of 250 millimeters in length was a thin copper film tightly wrapped around the lateral tube surface. This outer electrode. The outer electrode was fabricated in two versions, a continuous one and the fine sections electrode. Continuous electrode and fine section electrode. Fine section electrode consists of 16 sections of 13 millimeter in length with 2 millimeter gaps between each neighbor pair of sections. The outer electrode has a narrow slit cut out along the whole length of the tube in order to observe what happens inside the tube in the course of the slow wave propagation. The instant slow wave images were taken with a high-speed CCD four-frame camera. This is a photo of this camera. The exposure time of each frame is 60 nanoseconds. The time delay between frames is 5 nanoseconds and longer. there is question, why the fine section outer electrode was used? The answer is simple. The slow ionization wave propagation in the tube is accompanied by the surface charge deposition. Therefore, there is an interest to measure the surface charge distribution along the tube in time and to correlate it with the instant images of the propagating slow wave. This is why we performed the experiments with the use of the section's outer electrode. Each isolated section of which was connected to the ground by an individual current shunt equal to 50 ohms. Each section is connected to the ground, individual resistance. It allowed us to measure the radial current which deposits the electric charge onto the tube surface during slow wave propagation. This slide shows different combination of the tube and electric scheme which were used in our experiments, and more detailed explanation of each configuration will be given below. Now we will demonstrate the obtained results. At the beginning, I would like to show you the behavior of the positive direct slow ionization wave. This wave can be obtained if the far inner electrode is disconnected from the ground. So in this case, it is not possible to get the current from high voltage electrode to the ground. Only the current can go through the electric due to displacement current. This picture shows the set of instant images of positive direct ionization wave at a different moment. And one can see that configuration of the positive direct wave is similar to normal streamer. Like streamer. This wave looks like a streamer. However, so the length of the head of this so-called streamer is much longer compared to a natural streamer. This picture shows the electrical parameter of the ionization wave. It is interesting to mark that there is oscillation of current during the wave propagation. It means when we measure the velocity of this wave, in this case, it was discovered that positive direct wave propagate by a stepwise manner. Then accelerating, then slowing down. And there is a direct correlation between the current ionization wave and variation of the velocity of this wave. It is not it is a simple reason because in fact the direct ionization wave can be called the self-forming dynamic plasma capacitor, the capacity of which increases in time. The current through this capacitor is proportional to the slow wave velocity. This relation proves my statement. This is current and this is velocity. There is a direct relation. What what happens if we apply negative high voltage pulse to the high voltage electrode? What are the dynamics of the ionization wave? The negative direct ionization wave looks looks not like streamer, but their front is too long and strongly blurred. Besides, the velocity for propagation of negative direct wave is much higher compared to the positive direct ionization wave. And this difference is explained by different mechanism which responsible for appearance of seed electrodes. In the case of direct positive ionization wave, this mechanism is surface emission of electrons. But in the case of negative direct ionization wave, seed electrons appears from plasma. Therefore, this mechanism is much more effective and much more faster. Now, let us discuss another configuration when the far inner electrode is connected to the ground. In this case, it is possible to get a full breakdown inside the tube. And interesting to trace how down is formed. In the case of negative high voltage polarity, one can see on this oscillogram that the current of outer electrode that there is some delay. Some delay in the appearance of the direct negative slow wave. And after arriving the direct wave at the far grounded electrode, appear the back ionization wave that propagate towards the high voltage electrode. And it is interesting. This current has one sign, and this current has another sign. It means during this direct ionization wave, there is a process of surface charge deposition. And in this case, we have opposite process, process of discharging the before a deposited surface charge. And after that, the back waves arrives at the high voltage electrode, the breakdown, full breakdown is completed. In this case, the current between high voltage electrode and ground electrode increases, and plasma appears along the whole length of the tube. What about velocities of the direct and back ionization wave? This velocity velocities close to each other, and this velocity is close to 10 power 7 centimeter per second. Now this configuration again far inner electrode is connected to the ground. But we apply high voltage of positive polarity. In this case, initial stage is a positive ionization wave. again we can see the oscillation, the current. But in this case, we can see also the back ionization wave. And you can see a drastic difference between direct positive ionization wave and back ionization, structure of the back ionization wave. Direct ionization wave looks like a streamer, but back ionization wave looks like configuration with a very blurred front. And what is the reason? Reason is that the back positive wave travels through the plasma formed by direct ionization wave. And besides, the two poles are strongly charged. So conditions for propagation for direct ionization wave for positive polarity and for back ionization wave very different, and this difference the difference show the difference in the structure of this wave. Now about now some information that we get with use of the section electrode. In this case, we were possibly to get the set of current on each section. And in the case of the negative direct ionization wave, you can see that there is a strong current overlapping of the number sections at the same time. It correlates with the blurred image of the negative direct wave front. Because front is very long, it means simultaneously many sections can collect the current. Also, this picture show the distribution of the deposited charge along the sections, and we indeed can see that the quality of the deposited charge is high enough. The deposited surface charge density exceeds by a factor of 10-20 the typical surface charge density on the wall of NDC global discharge. You will see in the normal global discharge, the wall of the tube are charged by negative charge, but this the number density of this charge is not so much as in this case. The same configuration, but we use the positive high voltage pulse, and in the case we can observe the positive direct ionization wave. And in this case, you see there is no overlapping the current between neighboring section. And this effect relates with streamer-like sharp front of the positive direct ionization wave. You see again configuration of direct positive ionization wave looks like streamer. This configuration corresponds to the connection the far inner electrode to the ground, and in this case again we can obtain full breakdown inside the church tube, the tube. And we can also observe behavior of direct and back ionization wave. Again, we can see that in the case of direct ionization wave, the current or neighbor section practically there is no overlapping current on the neighboring sections. But another situation for the back ionization wave. In this case, there is a strong current overlapping of the neighbor sections at the same time. And this effect correlates with the blurred front of the back ionization wave. This is streamer-like configuration, and this is blurred front. And this effect correlates with this effect. And this configuration correlates with this result on current distribution over section. Now I would like to attract your attention to the next fact. In the case of non-ionized gas in the tube, there is a difference in both the structures and velocities of the positive and negative direct ionization waves. And this discrepancy is associated mainly with the difference of mechanisms providing seed electrons and their front. The existence of plasma created by the direct slow wave practically removed a difference in scenarios of the negative and positive wave ionization wave. You saw this circumstance. There is a question, will be the same effect for direct, not for back, but for direct negative and positive ionization wave if they propagate through the plasma formed in advance in the tube? To answer this question, the experiments with the use of the glow discharge formed in advance in the capillary tube were performed. They used schemes are shown below. This scheme was used study the negative direct ionization wave along glow discharge. This scheme was used to investigate the positive direct ionization wave along glow discharge. Now about the obtained results. At the beginning, the results on the negative direct ionization wave along the tube with the steady-state glow discharge. The parameter of glow discharge, the current 40 milliamps, and amplitude of the applied voltage is 4.5 kilovolts. In the case of negative direct ionization wave, the situation is practically the same that what's absorbed without glow discharge. We have again the blurred wave front and high, very high velocity of this graph shows the average velocity about 10^8 centimeter per second. I would like to read some of our findings related to this experiment. The direct negative wave structure is not changed by the Bichat plasma. However, the velocity behavior is changing. Instead of diminishing, the velocity increases with the distance from the high voltage electrode. The back ionization wave is absent. It's interesting. In this case, in the case of low discharge, the back ionization wave is absent. So after the direct ionization wave arriving at the grounded electrode, the surface charge starts to discharge practically simultaneously along the whole length of the tube. And in contrast to the non-ionized tube, the current through the tube starts to increase just after the direct wave arriving at the grounded electrode, but not after arriving at the back ionization wave at the high voltage electrode. So discharging process happens immediately after arriving direct ionization wave for this electrode, but not after the back wave arrives at the high voltage electrode. So existence of plasma in the tube essentially influences the behavior of the ionization wave behavior. The same experience was done with positive direct wave, and in this case we can see that direct have direct positive wave has blurred front instead of sharp front, which was similar to streamer. It means the existence of plasma in the tube essentially influences the behavior of the positive direct ionization wave as well. The velocity also strongly increases in the case of existence of plasma in the tube. I would like to list some of our findings. The glow discharge plasma changes the direct positive wave front. It becomes blurred. It moves with an acceleration towards the grounded electrode. Its velocity is equal to that for the direct negative ionization wave. It means there is no difference between positive and negative direct waves if there is plasma in the tube. Similar to the negative polarity, the back positive wave is absent as well. The full breakdown completion or the steady state DC establishment is correlated with a full discharging of the surface charge excess, because we saw that direct wave deposit very high density surface charge, and so it is necessary to discharge this charge in order to establish the DC flow discharge. Now, a bit of theory. For a qualitative explanation of the slow wave propagation, an analogy is often drawn with the voltage wave propagation along the coaxial line with distributed parameters R and C. And the transportation of potential phi along the line is described by the diffusion equation, this equation. This line, you know, at for a correction line with distributed parameters. This is the equation that describes the transportation of potential. However, this approach has essential drawback because it doesn't take into account the charge deposition on the surface tube. Therefore, if taken into account this circumstance, it is possible to get this modified equation. And this equation has the wave solution, and this solution can this solution have a qualitative agreement with the experiment. However, the diffusion approach to simplify it and therefore not be used for quantitative calculation of the slow ionization wave. It is necessary to conduct the numerical calculation with taking into account the specific features mentioned above. We have done this work. We have done a 2D model for slow ionization wave propagation. This is a set of equations that we used, and we take into account the emission, electron emission from the tube surface due to VUV light and due to gamma emission by positive ions. The calculation showed that wave velocity is close to the experimental one, and photo emission fluid is much higher compared to the ion gamma emission. This is some numerical results. One can see that front of the positive direct wave is not flat, but similar to a cone. And in the space between the cone and wall, this space, seed electrons appear due to photo emission from the wall. In this area, seed electron appear due to photo emission. And in this area, there is no the charge deposition to the wall, because only light there is in this area, but not light one. And second, the continuity of the total current is provided by the displacement current in this area. So now conclusion to the basic peculiarity of the breakdown formed by the slow ionization waves on the tube. First, slow ionization wave breakdown voltage noticeably exceeds the voltage providing the self-sustaining discharge. The threshold voltage for the direct qualitative wave appearance exceeds approximately twice that for the appearance of the direct negative wave. The low threshold voltage is accompanied by a long delay in the negative wave initiation. The positive direct wave front is steep and similar to the streamer head, but much longer. The positive direct seed propagation is supported by seed electrons due to surface processes, ion gamma processes, and e photo emission by VUV formed in the IV front. The negative direct wave front is strongly blurred compared to that of the direct positive wave. The negative direct wave propagation is supported by plasma electrons due to their drift towards the wave front and ahead the front. The front of negative and positive back waves are similar to each other and strongly blurred. In both cases, seed electrons are provided by the plasma formed by the direct waves. The direct wave forms in the tube strongly non-equilibrium conditions with plasma conductivity and surface charge appreciably exceeding those in a steady-state DC discharge. The back wave eliminates the surface charge excess, but increases extra the plasma density. After the back wave arrives at the high voltage electrode, the plasma and the discharge current slowly relax to those corresponding to the steady-state glow discharge. The steady-state glow discharge current is much lower compared to the slow ionization wave transient currents forming the discharge breakdown. Thank you very much for your kind attention.